Hello there, welcome back to my channel Easy Biology with me. So this is the second video tutorial, and here in this video I'm going to teach you about courtship behavior in case of arachnids. Okay, arachnids, here I'll be just taking the example of spiders and scorpions. Okay, so before that we'll just move into the basic definition of courtship behavior. Okay, so let me define over here. Courtship is actually, it is a complex set of behavioral interaction that occurs between males and females before, during and right after the act of mating. Okay, so this is actually defined as, it is nothing but a complex set of behavioral interaction. Okay, so here it happens between a male and female of the same species, and this is nothing but the interactions or the behavior which are shown before, during and just after the rite of mating itself is called as courtship behavior. Okay, so here courtship is a social behavior in which there is an interaction between male and female members of a species leading to a mating and reproduction. Okay, so I think this is very easy thing for you all to understand. But apart from this, let me tell you all that why mating occurs. Okay, why reproduction actually takes place. Okay, so there is an important thing called as genes, and the continuity of the genes is very necessary. Okay, so genes are very important because they act as a basic material for the evolution. Okay, so here we pass our genes to our progeny. Okay, which means that we are moving into a successful evolution where we are continuing our life as a progeny part. Okay, that is called as a good thing of evolution. So your continuity of the genes are nothing but the genes are transmitted from parents to the offsprings. Okay, and here the offsprings are further transmitting that genes to their progeny, and that's how we continue our generation. Okay, having a good generation is nothing but this occurs just after mating, and that is all due to the process of reproduction. Okay, and that's why we see that mating is a very important process, and that's why the continuity of genes are seen with the help of reproduction. Okay, and the second is individuals of same species. Okay, and this is very must and very necessary thing because individuals of the same species must mate, or else the evolution may take in a very different manner. Okay, if we want to continue our generation, the individuals of the same species are mating, and that's how they are, the genes are transmitted and they continue their generation. Okay, and here mating actually differs from one animal to the other animal. Okay, and here in case of mating, in case of animals, we say that a female has a very good right compared to the male. Okay, this is all because that female carries the egg. Okay, she has a parental care, so she invests lot more energy compared to that of the male. Okay, and that's why females have a good right of choice to select the male mate which she wants. Okay, and that's why what the male does is they go and just try to impress the females. Okay, in the simplest language which I can say is the males go and try to impress the female. Because the males have many large more amount of gametes, but those are smaller in size. Okay, they have many gametes in them, but those are actually smaller in size. While in the case of female, they have only one gamete. Okay, only one egg is produced at a time, but it differs. Okay, if the animal is having multi ova production at a time, so it differs from one animal to other. But compared to the male, females have a very less amount of the gametes. Okay, that's why what they do over here is the female goes on having a choice on the mate. Okay, and that's why the male over here is forced to exhibit himself to impress the female. Okay, and that's why this is the basic thing which occurs in case of reproduction in case of animal kingdom. Okay, and that is how the female has the majority of the choices to select the which mate she wants, because the purpose of only male is that he undergoes mating. He just gives his sperm to the female, and in some cases male leave that spot. Okay, and the further thing which is carried on, okay, after the eggs have been hatched, looking after the young ones, taking care of the young ones, okay, this is all actually done by the females, and that's why in case of animal kingdom, females have the majority of the right to select the male which she wants. Okay, and here the third thing is act of persuasion. Okay, an act of perseveration is very interesting thing because, yeah, I'll let you know in my further video that is in this class what act of perseveration actually refers to. Okay, and apart from this, act of perseveration is nothing but many of the animals are cannibalistic. Okay, they are very lot more aggressive compared to the other forms. Okay, so here many individuals which are aggressive, mating in them is quite dangerous for the male. Because whenever he tries to approach the female, he has been either killed or he has been eaten. Okay, that's why what happens is, it is the thing of a male that he has to go and he has to persuade the female. Okay, persuasion of female is nothing but he has to go and let her know that I am just about to mate with you and not about to fight with you. Okay, it is in a simplest language, and that's why act of persuasion matters a lot in case of animals. Okay, because animals are aggressive more of the time, and during which period, if the mating has to happen, okay, so aggressiveness must be cooled down, okay, aggressiveness must be totally suppressed, okay, if not, if the aggressiveness is not at all suppressed, then there may be the chances that male may die, okay, one of the two individuals may die, that's why aggressiveness must be suppressed, and the male has to persuade that he wants to have mating with the female so that they can continue their progeny. Okay, this is how it happens in case of animal kingdom. So in the next slide we can see that mechanism of mating. Okay, so in case of mechanism of mating, we see that there are four different types of mechanism or four different process in case of mechanism of mating. Okay, first thing is mate finding. Obviously the individual has to find the mate. Okay, if he doesn't find the mate, then obviously reproduction may not occur, right? Mating does not take place, then reproduction may not take place, and also progenies are not at all continued. That's why the first and foremost thing is you have to find a mate. Okay, in the sense that animals have to find their mate. Okay, mate may be in the different geographical zones, okay, of the same continuity of the geographical zone, they may be far distanced. Okay, so here mate finding refers that in case of animals, they try to find their mate with the help of sense of smell, sense of pheromones. Okay, the chemicals which are released, the sense of smell. Okay, with the help of these pheromones, the certain chemicals are smelled, okay, or inhaled. Okay, and this is how it makes them possible to detect the location of the mate. Okay, that's why sense of smell matters. Then sense of taste matters in some individuals. Okay, and apart from this, sense of hearing also matters. Because I guess you might have heard frogs croaking, right? So the frogs croak just because so that they can activate the females in their locality and the female can approach the male. Okay, in the other way too. So that's why even in case of birds, okay, birds have the good way of singing just because they can attract their mates. Okay, basically the singing in birds is actually done by the male, okay, not the females. Okay, so here mate finding is very necessary thing. Okay, that is the first and foremost thing of the mechanism of mating. And the second thing is persuasion. Okay, like I've told you, persuasion is nothing but relaxing the female, calming down her aggressiveness, and then persuading her that I am about to mate with you and I am not about to fight with you. Okay, that is called as persuasion. And then is synchronization. Okay, and here synchronization is nothing but both of them agree with each other to mate. That is called as synchronization. Basically synchronization we see in case of the bird kingdom. Okay, we basically see synchronization in case of bird animals. Okay, so what they do is say for example, if a male bird is calling a female bird, okay, it uses its voice to call the female, okay, and then female reciprocates, okay, and this is how they synchronize with each other. Okay, and that's how synchronization takes place. Okay, and then reproductive isolation. Okay, reproductive isolation is nothing but here in some cases the females or the males are farly distanced, okay, farly isolated, and that's why whatever the reproductive isolation is taking place, they can overcome that isolation. Okay, whatever distance, far distance they have been placed, they can overcome that and they can still undertake undertake the process of reproduction, and they can carry on their genes for the next generation. Okay, so in the next slide, I'll be just telling you about spiders. Okay, like I have told you, I'll be dealing about spiders and scorpions in case of arachnids. So right now, basically, I'll start with the spiders. Okay, so here I have two important stories in case of spiders. Okay, so spiders are predatory animals. Okay, predatory animals, like, they create certain web, and whichever smaller sized animal or smaller sized organism gets fixed into the web, they go on eat on that animal. Okay, they just go and eat on that animal. Okay, and this is what spider does is. Okay, and that's why they are called as predatory animal. Also, the females in case of spiders can be called as cannibalistic. Okay, because the females are very hungrier compared to the males. Okay, this is also a normal thing. Okay, apart from this, the females are actually very hungrier in case of animal kingdom rather than male, because they have they must invest lot more amount of energy when the mating period approaches. Okay, when the reproductive period approaches, female needs lot more amount of energy, because she has to lay eggs, and after the egg hatches out, okay, the young one hatches out, she has to look after them, she has to care them. Okay, that's how the female invests lot more amount of energy compared to the males. Okay, and that's why the females are lot more aggressive, because whichever the animal or organism they see, they just try to go and feed on them. Okay, and that's why it is a threat to a male spider over here, because whenever he approaches the female individual, it is a risk for him that he may be eaten alive by the female individual. Okay, and that's why mating is dangerous and difficult for the weaker males. Okay, weaker males are not at all able to mate with the female unless and until he is brainy enough. Okay, there occur such evidences over here also. Whenever the male is also weak, he tries to use his brain a lot. Okay, and tries to get over this weakness, and tries to successfully transmit his gene with the help of mating. Okay, so here mating is actually dangerous dangerous and difficult for the weaker males in case of spiders. Okay, so what they have to do is, they have to do two things over here, spiders. Okay, first is stimulate female sexually. Okay, if they look after a female, okay, so after looking at her, they have to stimulate her. Okay, because it is a reproductive time, both of them know. But here female is actually totally investing her mind into having certain food for her, because she is aggressive for now and she is very hungry for now, right? So here what he has to do is, he has to first stimulate her sexually, that he has to persuade her that I am here to mate with you. Okay, and then suppress her non-sexual characters. Okay, so here suppress her aggressiveness. Suppress her non-sexual characters are nothing but suppressing her aggressiveness. Okay, and just evoking her sexual characters. This is how he can do. So here I can give you one example. Okay, so in some species of spiders, what they do is, they just take certain animals. Okay, any smaller insects or bee. Okay, for now you just remember that they just take a smaller insects, and they just ooze out the silk around that particular insect. Okay, the silk is totally encircling the insect, which is entrapped over here, and the silk is been totally oozed out. Okay, it looks like a gift. Okay, a gift which he presents to his female during the mating process. Okay, and this gift is actually called as nuptial gift. Okay, and this gift are very common in case of some species of spiders, wherein silk wrapped nuptial gifts, or a gift of silk itself, wherein a male presents female with a silk wrapped prey items called as nuptial gifts. Okay, prey items, basically if we get certain insects, that is well enough. Okay, if he is not getting any insects, then what he has to do? He just uses his brain a lot. Okay, during this time, what he does is, he just wraps certain stones or certain dry leaves into a silk weaving threads, and then he just go and presents to the female of his own individual species. Okay, so here now the female, whenever the male gifts him something, obviously she is lot more excited, right? So she tries to unwrap that particular silk wrappings. Okay, and then when she tries to unwrap that, it is a good chance for the male spider so that he can mate with her. Okay, and that's how he utilizes this process. Okay, that's how he just actually gives certain elements to the female and have his own mating process with the female, so that he is successful into transmitting his sperm into the orifice of the female. Okay, this is how it takes place in case of certain animal individuals of spiders. Okay, this is one example, that is gifting the nuptial gifts. Okay, and other is the next thing is mechanical means of approaching female. Okay, so mechanical means of approaching females is nothing but it is also called as serenading the female. Okay, just a common example, in case of humans too. Okay, what the male does is they try to impress the females a lot, right? They try to impress the girls a lot. So what they do, they certain times they give a gift, and in some cases the male tries to play certain songs, so with the help of in a musical instruments, okay, be it the guitar, violin or any other instrument, he just tries to impress the females, right? This actually happens in case of humans. Okay, even in case of spiders, you see the same thing. Okay, the mechanical means of approaching female is nothing but plucking the thread of the web, and it is species specific frequency. Okay, so female right now, just imagine that she is sitting at the center of the web, right? So this is a web, so female is sitting at the center of the web, and now male is approaching to the female, and male is somewhere over here. Okay, so he looks at the center of the web and he sees that female is at the center, right? So now what he does, he tries to go on plucking the threads of the web. Okay, whenever he plucks a thread or whenever he cuts the thread, silk thread of the web, there are certain vibrations created, and these vibrations are nothing but they are acting as the serenading for the female. Okay, these vibrations are actually heard in the song for them. Okay, that's why the male serenades the female. Serenade is nothing but they create a mechanical vibrations, mechanical sound by plucking the thread of the females. Okay, at a species specific frequency. Okay, so here keep one thing in mind, that he has to serenade at a species specific frequency. Because if he just goes and plucks the thread of the other species, obviously he is destroying the home of other species animal, and the other thing is he is being eaten alive by that other individual. That's why this happens as a species specific frequency. Okay, it happens only in the same species. Okay, so here the same thing. Okay, the third point is if he oozes the female of different species. Okay, like I told you, if he goes and sits on the web of the different species female and tries to go on plucking the thread, obviously he's been totally killed and eaten by that female individual of the other species. And the third thing is, if he plays a wrong tune, okay, obviously we need a good tune, right? If he plays a wrong tune, and even in that situation, he's been attacked and totally killed by the female individual. Okay, this is how it happens in case of spiders. Okay, this is how I gave you about two examples in case of spiders. One is presenting a nuptial gifts. Okay, nuptial gifts are in the form of certain insects which are wrapped into the silk. Okay, silk by the web. And whenever the female tries to unwrap that griff, the male utilizes this particular chance and tries to fertilize with the female. And the next is the serenading the female. Tries to go on plucking the thread of the web. Okay, and it is at species specific frequency. Okay, so this is about courtship behavior in case of spiders. Okay, now let's move to mating in case of scorpions. Okay, so yeah, I have given you a word called as prominate aduous, right? So prominate aduous is nothing but this is a type of mating dance given by the scorpions. Okay, so here I have placed you two pictures over here. Okay, the picture in which the scorpions which appear to be bluish, that is very clear compared to the other one, because here you see that both the male and the female, okay, both the individuals are holding their pedipalps very firmly. Okay, their pedipalps are held very firmly, And you can see another thing is the tail is been upraised. Okay, you can see the upraising of the tail, and this is how actually this is the position for the mating in case of scorpions. Okay, so here the promenade A duet is nothing but it is a type of ritual dance wherein the both individuals holding the pedipalp. Okay, imagine this is one individual and this is other individual. They are holding the pedipalp and tries to move in forward and backward direction. Okay, this is the direction which they follow, and this is a particular mating dance which is seen in case of scorpion, and that's why it is called as promenade. Okay, and this particular forward and backward direction takes place for about 10 minutes to an hour until they find a perfect location for them to deposit the spermatophore from the male. Okay, so this is how just move into this direction for several minutes to hour to find a suitable place for the spermatophore deposition. Okay, and when they find the perfect place to deposit the spermatophore, what the male does is, male deposits spermatophore on the ground and then maneuvers the female. Okay, maneuvers the female means he pushes the female over the spermatophore where he has deposited it on the ground. Right, so this is a ground here at this location he has deposited spermatophore, and now he maneuvers the female onto this particular region so that the spermatophores are sucked into the genitals of the female. Okay, and lastly the spermatophores are sucked up by the female orifice. Okay, this is how mating ritual occurs in case of scorpions. Okay, so at the last of the video, in the description box, I'll also just the video by the Smithsonian channel. Okay, this is a video which I have got from the YouTube other channel. So I'll just hit the link of that YouTube video into the description box. So right after ending this video lecture, you can just go and look at the promenade device by the scorpion. Okay, so this is about mating, that is courtship behavior in case of arachnids, that is I have told you about spiders and scorpions. So if you like the video, just give a thumbs up, that is just hit the like button. And if you really like this video, okay, so share it with your friends and don't forget to subscribe, to hit the subscribe button. Okay, thank you.